friends, welcome back to my channel. I've missed you. I really have. If you're new, thank you. If you're returning, thank you for returning. Make sure to subscribe, click the like button, leave a comment, share my videos, click that bell notification, do all that good stuff. Now, we're going to get into some goodies. I made a barbecue pork chop. We have corn. There's macaroni cheese. And I got some cauliflower. Now I'm teeing up. Sam's must have been having a good sale because we get in Costco. I got the big old thing of cauliflower for like $3. It was a big one. I don't know, maybe that's not cheap, I don't know, but it was a nice big one. Ooh, Lord, it's coming all pieces. Well, I watched one video. This lady says, bullet hole. Never bullet hole. Mine comes all crumbly when you try to cut it. I don't know if that's gonna work. Let me get some of this soaked food down. Hold on a second. Somewhere out here thought my dog again. I have him outside. Hold on. Okay. I'm back. You tell the family to keep the dogs outside while I'm doing my videos, they don't listen. They do whatever they want to do. Well, it's mostly my mother. I think she's got Alzheimer's, dementia, or something. It's really coming, gotten worse the last few weeks. You tell her something? 5 minutes later, she don't remember nothing. It was the other day when the people came to repair my water sprinklers. Every 5-10 minutes, she kept asking me, who are those people walking through the house? What's all that noise? Why are the dogs barking? Over and over. Anyone else have a family member with Alzheimer's, dementia? Well, they started her on this medicine for her hands because they shake like it. I think they did just into her brain. She was some forgetful, I saw. But since she started taking that medicine, I'll tell you what. She can't remember. Or nothing. My dad died from Alzheimer's a few years ago. Sad to see my mother come through. Whatever. I noticed on the video go ahead, her edit's already gone up the time I post this one. I tell you what, I ain't using a wireless microphone. I noticed every once in a while, so like I said to the dean, I'm starting to like watching my videos. I'm funny. I'm funny as Roseanne. Well, I noticed every once in a while during my video, it was cutting off and on a few times. Don't boil your cauliflower whole. I'm still making a mess. I feel like a macaroni cheese. I only got just a little spoonful of it because I'm trying to cut down on my carbs. Keep going now. It's my foot on this bottom of this table. I know corn has carbs too, so you don't have to leave me a message because I know that. Let me see. What can we talk about then? Oh, well, this is going to be old news, but where did they find the key Largo? The FBI is reading Donald Trump's Key Largo. Is that what it's called? Whatever it's called. I say they're looking for some Girl Scout cookies. Donald Trump's Dasher Girl Scout cookies. I haven't had Girl Scout cookies in so many, oh my god, so many years. Early 90s. A friend of mine's daughter was selling them. Back then, I think they were like $3, they were about $3.50 a box. That was expensive for some cookies.
She sold me them cookies for like $15 a box. Well, that's one reason I stopped. Stuff from anybody, because I don't care if they're my kid's father's spinal tiggy again. They're acquaintances. They're not friends. They're acquaintances. And take advantage of you like that. And so many years. One thing with Girl Scouts, they don't put them prices up there. They could just make up what they want to make up. So I always thought the cookies were that much. Then I happened to find out, I don't know, they were about the same price, $4 a box or whatever. I remember telling somebody, I said, Pam, and I had like 6 or 7 boxes of them Girl Scout cookies. I'm buying things for you. Then I started hearing, the cookies have gotten smaller, the boxes have gotten smaller, you got less cookies in them. And then it went up on price. And then I think they got rid of the ones we liked. Well, everybody likes those mint ones. I found those Walmart ones for $1. They're pretty close to those. So you want those mint Girl Scout cookies? Thin mints? I think they're called. Go to Walmart. $1. Put them in the freezer. They're delicious. I bought some a couple months ago, got home with them. They were on the counter for a couple of days. And I was like, oh, I'm gonna try me a cookie. I'm gonna cook these with them. I had to wait, you know. And so, last time I put an order at Walmart, I ordered some, got some, and I put them in the freezer. They were delicious. I wonder what happens to all those people who makes those cookies. You only have them for just a few months. Do they work year round? I don't. Girl Scout Cookie Factory. I never became a Girl Scout. I was a brownie. I was so shy. I would just sit there. I wouldn't do nothing. I was just so shy. I wanted my mama. I was always so shy. I would never talk to nobody. at the hospital. Said, shut me up. So I did. My mother said, well, guess you were saving up all those years to talk. But now, I just talk to random strangers. I was talking to these people today at the hospital. My mother's getting her test done. And I hear these people talking about over in the UK. Oh, we don't talk to each other. Well, that's not very friendly. Well, I'll tell you, learn something about your fellow man, about your neighbors. Countries are in conflict all the time. Get out there and learn to talk to your neighbors. Learn about each other. It's fun to talk and learn. I love to learn new things every day. You know, it's just I don't care if it's on YouTube or watching TV shows or reading about something or, you know, learn about something every day. So, it's good to learn. I learn more nowadays than I did in school. Like I've said in my other videos, it was hot. We didn't have no air conditioning. Some teachers have some fans. So, well, you get that hot Texas heat. That humidity with that fan. It's hot. Almost then you have the 80s hair with all that hairspray. And the makeup base in. Oh my goodness, it be sweat. We had one girl in high school, I remember. She sat right next to me in history class. I don't know what that girl's name was. See her. She must got up 4 o'clock in the morning, do her hair, and put that much makeup on. When you're 16 years old or so, 15 years, why do you need so much makeup? Always bought it natural or whatever. I know, but still, it wasn't good makeup. But still, you still had to put powder or whatever on. You hear the door. That's Atticus. That was a really good pork chop. I tell you what, my stomach's been doing so much better. I paid that $200 for that test. Silly stomach. I guess it just wanted me to pay $200 to say, hey, you're lactose intolerant. And every day they keep sending me something, trying to sell me something. Some kind of new test. Well, you can speak to somebody for $99.99 or something. And every day you can eat two foods and eliminate them.
I can do that for myself for free.
I'll tell you what, my dogs were as needy as children. I can't get crap done around the house. I love them to death. Can I get anything done? It's like having a 2 or 3 year old running around the house all the time. I've been trying to make this doctor's appointment for my mother for a month. For her feet. Can I get on the phone to make this appointment? No, because every time I get on the phone, they all start humping each other and acting up like a bunch of little children or something. And it's like, well, I hope little children ain't humping each other, but. And it's like, if these people on the telephone see what my dogs are doing while I'm trying to talk to them, they'd be embarrassed. They'd be so red and embarrassed. My Brutus. I hired him. I guess for 6 or 7 months before I had to put him to sleep. Every time I got on that phone, if I had to make a phone call, I got a call. That dog would attack me. I don't literally attack me. He just got. Now he'd come leaping at you. I can never use the phone. And he knew. I don't know how. Probably 10, 15 seconds before the phone would ring. I could see in his eyes that he's like, he's fixing, I was like, oh, someone's fixing a call. And he knew. My phone was fixing the ring. Every time. I'm not gonna ever put why I had to put him to sleep. I know, oh, I hate this table. I know there was another popular YouTube channel, the man and woman, I don't know what their name was. Last year, I don't know what their name was. I started following them, I don't know what happened to them. They had a lot of subscribers. But they ended up having to put their dog to sleep because it tried to attack their baby. And I think she was pregnant at the time with another one. We just had another one. I can't remember if it bit one of them. I don't know. It was a family dog or whatever. And everybody loved it or whatever. And they had to put the dog to sleep because try to take the baby, and I do understand. You know, people gave them such grief and just terrible, you know, hate towards them. I'm about finished. That is, I think, Josephine. People couldn't understand why they put that dog to sleep. But I think I wrote him a nice little comment or something. Or something about it. And, people don't do it. Because you don't know. I used to say that too. You know, I'd leave my baby with an English bulldog. Well, let me take one. This one here? You don't leave no baby with this one. He will fight sometimes. Him and Brutus. They got into fights. It was a nice fight. And so, and I've heard people saying, oh, I'll just leave my baby with this dog or whatever. And it's like, you know what? Doesn't matter if the dog's 10 years old, as sweet as can be. It's a dog. It will turn if it wants to turn. It will attack. So don't leave your baby or little child, especially pulling their ears and his tails. It's not fun for the dog. Don't do that. You know? And you sure don't want nothing to happen to your baby. You know? So, I remember we used to do that. And we thought it was funny, but, you know, good thing that we didn't get attacked. I didn't get attacked. So, later on, I did get attacked. I'll give you a quick story. My mother had this English bulldog. Dog went in heat, and there was another dog. Well, they were doing it outside in the yard. She was yelling and screaming, get the dog, get the dog, pull them apart. Well, I'm gonna tell you what, when you got two dogs together, you can't pull them apart. I'm gonna tell you what happens, you get dog bit. I'm bleeding. I still got scars on me. The dog tore the crap out of me. And I'm crying, screaming, blood just everywhere. So she goes, I'm telling her, take me to the doctor. I gotta go to the doctor. I was like, I had big, deep wounds that needed stitches. So she takes me to her when they used to have a hospital. We get halfway to her. But we come into the almost into her, and she turns around, and I said, I'm crying, and she's all like, where are you going, she goes, going home, she goes, I can't take you to the doctor, the dogs haven't been vaccinated, they'll put the dogs to sleep. I said, you're worrying about your dogs, when I'm sitting here, got big gashes in my arms and my hands, and I need stitches, and she just takes me home, and yeah, so I'm all arm and stuff, and I have, Josephine, stop it, scars and stuff where that dog tore the crap out of me. Yeah, but I must have been about 14, 15 years old. Man, I was so mad. So, make sure your dogs are vaccinated. If something happens, back then, they really didn't have laws that the dogs had to be vaccinated. So, but I'm going to end it here. I got this whiny little 2-year-old. 3-year-old. She's only a year old, but she acts like a 2-year-old. So, I'm gonna let y'all go, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.